So hello guys, in this video I'm going to tell you some most important civil engineering interview questions which will help you to crack different competitive exams as well. If you are first time in this channel, then please press the subscribe button so you will not miss anything about civil engineering. So let's get started. In this video I'm going to talk about some basic concept which you must know, and I will show you how different basic concepts are interrelated with each other so you can understand better. So the first question is, what is section modulus? It is defined as the ratio of moment of inertia about neutral axis to the distance of extreme fiber from neutral axis. So these terms like neutral axis, extreme fiber, moment of inertia may be unknown to you. So through this question, I'm going to explain you bending stress, shear force, bending moment, neutral axis and moment of resistance. So what is shear force? Shear force of a section of a beam is the algebraic sum of forces acting normal to the axis on either sides of the section. So let's consider this is a section of a beam and a force of 5 kN are acting, and the force of 10 kN is also acting on the section of a beam. So shear force is nothing but the algebraic sum of forces acting on the beam. So the resultant shear force of that section will be 10 plus 5 is 15 kN. And what is bending moment? Bending moment is nothing but the algebraic sum of moment of all the forces acting on the beam on either sides of the section. So if the moment is acting here, or if another moment is acting here, so bending moment will be the algebraic sum of this moment and this moment for that section of the beam. Okay. So let's understand what is bending stress. So before knowing what is bending stress, let's understand what is stress. So when we apply external forces on a beam, there are some internal forces. There are some internal forces which resist the applied external force is known as stress. So what is bending stress? Bending stress is nothing but when we apply bending moment. So when we applied bending moment and the stress generated in the beam to resist the bending moment is called bending stress. Okay. And when we apply shear force, stress generated on the section of a beam or any other section to resist the applied shear force is called shear stress. So let's now understand what is neutral axis. Okay, so this is a section of a beam and let us consider this is the neutral axis of that section. If that section is subjected to bending, then the section will be look like that. Okay. And let us consider this is the neutral axis. So there are some layers. Some layers are here which subjected to tension due to bending, and there are some layers which subjected to compression, but there is a layer which is free from tension and compression is known as neutral axis. So this axis is nothing but the axis which is free from tension and compression after the application of moment. So before coming to the moment of resistance, let me clear the definition of section modulus. So I already told you the definition, but let me show you by drawing a figure. So let us consider this is a section of a beam, cross section of a beam. Okay, let us consider this is a cross section of a beam and this is neutral axis. So this axis is free from tension and compression. Okay, then what is the definition? The definition is the it is defined as the ratio of moment of inertia about neutral axis. So if the section is rectangular, the moment of inertia of the rectangular section, we know if this is B and this is D, it will be BD cube by 12. Okay, so this is the moment of inertia of the rectangular section. So moment of inertia of different section we can be calculated, but for the square section the moment of inertia will be BD cube by 12. For the circular section the moment of inertia will be pi d to the power 4 by 64 and d is the diameter of the circle. Okay, like that. And for the square section, if the sides are A, then the moment of inertia will be A to the power 4 by 12. Okay. Then distance of extreme fiber from neutral axis. So the upper fiber where the load is applied is called the extreme fiber. So this is the extreme fiber and this is the neutral axis. So in case of symmetrical section, as you can see, this is a symmetrical section, the neutral axis will pass from the center of gravity. Okay, so center of gravity will be in the center of the section. So center of the section is D by 2 and neutral axis will pass from D by 2 and the distance from the extreme fiber and neutral axis is D by 2. So section modulus is nothing but the ratio between moment of inertia and distance from the extreme fiber. So that is BD cube by 12 by D by 2. That's it. Okay, and section modulus is denoted by Z and moment of inertia is I and the distance from neutral axis, okay, to extreme fiber is denoted by Y. So section modulus is also denoted by Z is equal to I by Y. Now come to the last topic, that is moment of resistance. As I already told you, after bending, some longitudinal layers are in compression and some are in tension. The total sum of compression, and the total sum of tension, are equal but opposite and parallel. Okay, so hence they create an internal couple. So sum of compression and sum of tension are equal, opposite and parallel, and hence they create an internal couple which is known as moment of resistance or MR. MR is equal to sigma into Z. Sigma is the permissible bending stress of the section. So you no need to find out the value of sigma because the value of sigma will be given in the problem. All you need to find out the value of Z, that is section modulus, and I already told you how to find the value of Z. Okay, and So you can easily find out the value of moment of resistance. So in this video, I explained how different topics of mechanics of structure, bending stress, shear force, bending moment, neutral axis, moment of resistance, and section modulus are interrelated with each other. Okay, so you can understand better, so I will tell you in that manner. So in the next video, I will come with some more interesting topic. So do like, do share, and if you have any confusion, please comment below. I will definitely try to solve your confusion. Thanks.